Hello, and welcome to my podcast, Home Comfort Tactics. Today, I do want to highlight an interesting thing that happened to me here over the past 2 months. And it's something that is, you know, important to me because I'm not sure, you know, if anybody here listening knows, but I'm a former window contractor. And I did that for 9 years, and I really believed in what I was doing. And I still think windows are fantastic for a certain set of reasons, and I'll kind of get to that. But I had an experience back in January of 2018 where the two worlds that I had started living in and then eventually graduated to, they collided. And what I mean by that is I was a window contractor turned certified energy auditor. And then I was in a situation where my understanding and my skills and the testing that we do as an energy auditor were put to the test. Because I had a person who had leaky windows and they swore they were leaky and they wanted me to show them how they were leaky. And the information that I was providing to them and the results that I was showing them contradicted what they thought. And at that moment, it was an aha moment for me because, yes, I had read about these things, and that is what really got me hooked on being a home performance contractor and being an energy auditor, because it was bucking, you know, some of the thought processes that I had been, you know, having for 9 years. But when I got in front of a person who was believing, you know, some of the things that I myself was once teaching, and we were going around together investigating the windows, and we were seeing that they were not the source of the problem, you know, it all made just so much sense to me. And that was back in 2018, January. And here we are, 2023. And here's my story. And it's about windows. And I think it's important because what happens around this time of year, and especially as we get closer to fall, and I'm not trying to fast forward summer or anything, but people start calling about windows. I've written a lot of things about windows. I have a lot of experience with windows. When I started my website, I was, you know, going deep into windows and writing about how they're manufactured and things like that. So as a result, people sometimes find my information and they call. So I can tell when there's an uptick in replacement window inquiries and people are in the market for that. And then yesterday I did an energy audit where the homeowner was convinced and to the point where I could not and probably and would not try to convince them otherwise, because they've already signed a contract, but they are convinced that their home is drafty and cold due to the windows and proceeded to replace 22 of them. And I'm not even going to get into, you know, how much or anything like that. But what I want to, you know, explain here is that windows, and I think the controversy and what I'm about to say, this is what I want to say. Windows, they're not the source of your comfort problems. They're not. Go back to my story. So when I, back in January of 2022, I went out, it was a cold day, and I did an energy audit for a nice couple in Silver Spring, Maryland. And you can see here, I'm in my mind's eye right now talking, but I'm going to put some of these photos of the windows in the house up. It's a little older rancher style, I think built in the 60s. And here's the progression to sort of get to the point. Did the energy audit, did an air pressure test, also known as the blower door test. And just to kind of stop and put that into a frame, the blower door test measures how leaky a house is. Now, we're not going to compare the house from, you know, across the street to your, no, it's a comparison to yourself. But it's a number that tells us in a quantifiable way how leaky the house is. And it's obtained through a pressure test. And essentially all that is a fan that pulls air out of your house, and there's a little meter. It's a sensitive device that not only records the airflow, but also the pressure. So every house has gotten down to the same negative pressure, which isn't much. It's just a little bit to put enough on the envelope of the house, nothing that anybody will feel inside. And as that's happening, we get a recorded airflow number. And that's where the story gets interesting, because I took the initial reading in January 2022, and the total number, let's not get into exactly what all this means, but it was 4,187 CFM, which is cubic feet per minute. That's how much air was flowing at the front door during the test before any work was done on the home. Now, I'm running around talking, writing these blogs, talking to people when I do my energy audits about, you know, because everybody thinks it's the windows. And I'm running around telling people windows are, they're only counting for 10% of your home's air leakage. 10% is what I'm attributing to the windows. So back to it. Fast forward 1 year, January 2023. So the homeowner didn't do anything. I hadn't heard anything. I always send a report, a comprehensive report after the energy audit. I always send a work scope if applicable, you know, if it's required or needed or asked for or requested. So in that case, I did, and I follow up, but I'm not a pest. You know, I know, you know, if somebody's interested, they know where to find me. And so I didn't hear anything. And then 1 year, fast forward, I get an email, and they're ready to go. And they are excited because not only are they ready to go on the insulation, but they've signed a contract for windows. And they just want to make sure that, you know, if they get all the work done, like we had discussed before, can they also get the rebate on the windows? And I said, sure, absolutely, you can. So here we are. We're in a situation where the homeowner has now gotten the energy audit. They've gotten the house tested for air leakage. They are in the process of getting the house air sealed and insulated by me through my company, Home Trust Remodeling. And they're also in process of getting all of their windows replaced. So we are going to see sort of three stages of air leakage in this house: before any work, after air sealing, and then after the windows. And that's exactly what I did. And here are the results. It's astounding. Okay, now I am going to put some pictures up so that as I'm talking through this a little bit, there is some evidence of why. And it'll kind of tie into the importance of it. And it's going to help people understand that these places that I'm pointing out, sometimes they even seem invisible for two reasons. One, inside you cannot see where these are. And up in the attic, they're covered by the insulation. So it is just invisible problems. But what you're going to see here is a tremendous difference in results. So testing, let's go back, 4,187 cubic feet per minute flowing through. Went out there, I think it was in February, and we air sealed the heck out of the house. We got up in the attic and we sealed all the cracks, crevices. We did the work. We, you know, sealed everything we possibly could, added insulation. Went down in the basement, and because of the older construction, we used spray foam in the basement. Two-part spray foam, closed cell on the rim and band joists. We popped all the ceiling tiles away 2 feet from the foundation wall, and we got up there and meticulously insulated and sealed the entire, well, the accessible rim joist. And after that was done, I left because the windows were not put in. And about 2 weeks later, it dawned on me, Eric, you need to get out there and you need to test that house before they put those windows in so we can see what's the difference and what's the result. Okay, so here's how it went. I went out there on a Saturday morning. The homeowner was so nice. He let me come out there and test again, knowing that I had to go back and test after the windows are done, because that's the way it goes. Once you complete all of the measures, so the insulation, the air sealing, and the windows, that's when you do the final test out so that you can get the rebate. Excuse me. Okay, here's the result. After air sealing the attic and the basement, did the test a couple weeks later, and the result was 2,042 CFM, cubic feet per minute, flowing at the door. A 51% reduction in air leakage. 51%. So, here's where windows are beautiful. They will open up your view. They will allow you to get a nice cool breeze on those nice fall and spring days that we have, particularly in Maryland. But they're not going to be getting you a more comfy or cozy house in the winter. So the drum roll, please. Okay, so here's how it works out. After the windows went in, about 2 or 3 weeks later, I can't remember, I went back out and I did the blower door test, the air leakage test again. So it went from 4187 after air sealing down to 2042. And after the windows were put in, it went from 2042 down to 1805, 1,805. So that was a difference of, I'm going to do the math here, 2042. 1805, 237 cubic feet per minute. So as a percentage of the overall air leakage that the house started with, 4187, that percentage, that 237 divided by the 4187, it comes out to a 6% reduction. And I don't even want to... And I probably should, and maybe I will if anybody is interested in the comments or something like that. But I don't even want to talk about the difference in cost. Now, again, I don't want to sound like a jerk here. Windows are wonderful. They're an enhancement. They beautify home. They are great for curb appeal. There's nothing like a nice view. For example, this house had storm windows over top of old wood windows. And you could barely see out. So yes, you know, there are many, many, many great benefits from getting new replacement windows. But what I am really trying to say, and the moral of this story, is don't replace your windows to make your house more comfortable. Do it to make it more beautiful and more functional. Thank you for listening. If you're interested in anything that I've had to say, I've got a few other of these podcasts, and I'm going to keep making them. Just got ideas flowing out of my brain. My website is hometrustremodeling.com in Maryland. You can also find me at ericgans.com. Anyway, thanks for listening.